I'm David Jurgens. I'm an associate professor in the School of Information and Department of Computer Science, here today to talk to you about how to prompt GPT-like systems to give really good answers. So what is a prompt? A prompt is that piece of text that you write that's kind of like instructions to tell ChatGPT or GPT-4 or U-M GPT how to generate an answer for you. And there's lots of ways that we can ask humans for instructions or for answers. And so there's many different ways that we can ask these systems. So I'm going to give you three tips today on how to do it. The first tip that I want to provide to you is to think about what's the workflow that you're trying to accomplish with ChatGPT. If you think about just asking ChatGPT to write an essay, it'll give you something. But if you think about what it means to, say, write an essay, there's titles and outlines, there's finding grammar errors, there's looking for logical flow, there's even like trying to have it edit or give suggestions, like if you handed it to a friend, like where could I improve this piece? And the GPT systems are good at all of those steps. So you as the human need to figure out, where am I strong at? Maybe I'm really bad at coming up with outlines, but I can ask ChatGPT to write me an outline and then I'll fill in the blanks from there. So having the system break down the steps for you and work on specific pieces can make your output better and allow you as the end user to get better quality output in the long run. The second tip I want to give to you is to think about structuring your inputs. If you think about writing a recipe that you might hand to someone else, you don't just write one long paragraph. Instead, you kind of break it down. There's like lists of instructions or specific steps. And these kind of GPT systems really benefit from that. So don't be afraid to add new lines with stars and asterisks to look like a list, or to provide really clear instructions on what you want in each step of the way. The more detail you can provide, the better the system will do as a result. The third piece I'd like to provide to you is to think about the perspective of what you want. Do you want this to be an answer for yourself or for a boss, for a student, for someone else? And to ask it to add specificity, to write this answer as if it's going to this person. You could ask it to take on the perspective of this. Pretend that you're a professor, pretend that you're an employer. And you may get different answers that can help prompt you to give a better response in the end. In addition, you can ask GPT to give you specific kinds of output. It could be you want a table or a list or a suggestion of edits or to bold something in what you've typed in. All of these things are possible if you ask it for specific kinds of outputs that can help you use the system faster and more effectively. So these GPT systems are incredibly powerful and you can use them for all sorts of things. So don't be afraid to play around with the prompt and use lots of different variations to see if you get an output. There's no wrong way to do it, but there's lots of ways you can get different answers. So good luck in your prompting and enjoy using U-M GPT.